On the behalf of Government Engineering College Banswara, I, Dr. Sunil Gadwal, welcomes you once again in video lecture classes. As previously we had discussed about fuel, cracking, reforming. Today we are going to discuss about synthetic petrol. So as we know that a large amount of gaseous, saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbon are produced by carbonization, cracking, reforming, fractional distillation column process. The day-by-day increasing demand of gasoline forced to synthesize petrol from other sources. The petrol can be synthesized in laboratory by two methods. One is Fischer-Tropsch method and second is Bruzzese method. So today we are going to discuss about Fischer-Tropsch method. In this method, a mixture of water gas, as we know that water gas is produced when we pass steam over a red hot cock, and addition of hydrogen gas mixture at a hot chamber keeping temperature 200 to 300 degrees centigrade, and in the presence of 5 to 25 atmospheric pressure due to high temperature and a mixture of catalyst and pressure, it produces a mixture of hydrocarbon which is useful for internal combustion engine. The following steps involved in Fischer-Tropsch method. First is water gas production. Water gas can be produced by passing steam over red hot cock at 1200 degrees centigrade. So this is the cock, as we know that the source of carbon plus steam, we pass it over 1200 degrees centigrade, it will make CO plus H2O, and this mixture is known as water gas. Purification of water gas. A mixture of water gas UH2 is purified by passing it over moist Fe2O3 to removal of H2S and HCN, and a mixture of Fe2O3 plus Na2CO3 for the removal of organic sulfur. And C is the conversion of water gas into a mixture of saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbon. The purified water gas and hydrogen gas mixture compressed at 5 to 25 atmosphere and passed through a converter containing catalyst, which is a mixture of cobalt 100 parts, thorium 5 part, magnesia 8 part, and a special type of sand which is known as Kesselger earth is 200 parts at 200 to 300 degrees centigrade. In these conditions, a mixture of saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbon will form. So this is the NCO plus H2, the water gas, plus additional H2 hydrogen we will add, then it will give CnH2n plus NH2O. If we take excess of hydrogen, then it will give CnH2n plus 2 saturated alkanes or hydrocarbons. So D part of this process is cooling and condensation of products. The outcoming hot gaseous mixture, various hydrocarbon mixture from the exothermic reaction are lead to a cooler where a crude oil is obtained. Fractional distillation, the crude oil obtained in this process is purified by fractional column distillation, as we had discussed in carbonization method, then in reforming methods. So this is the diagram for Fischer-Tropsch method. As you can see that from here we are passing a water gas, then additional hydrogen we are adding, and this mixture is entering in purification chamber where in the first chamber on plates we are keeping moist Fe2O3, and in another chamber we are keeping a mixture of Fe2O3 plus Na2CO3 to remove the organosulfur compounds. So when this water gas and hydrogen gas will come here and it will travel like this, then from here, then again it will enter in the second purification chamber from downwards, and it will move towards upward and come out here. This is the catalytic chamber where we are maintaining the temperature 200 to 300 degrees centigrade, and the pressure which is 5 to 25 atmosphere, and the mixture of cobalt, thorium, magnesia and Kieselguhr earth is 105, 8 and 200 ratio kept in this catalytic chamber. Then these gases, hydrogen and water gas will enter here. In these certain conditions it will form saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbons mixture. That mixture will come out from here, and with the help of cooler we will separate the gas and gasoline mixture, and this gasoline is again purified by fractional column distillation. And as we know that in fractional column distillation the vapor will enter from the here, and these are the buffer plates which allow only the vapors to enter and move in a specific direction. So the vapors will come here, or from here it will come and move towards upward. It will not allow them to go back. So according to the boiling point of various hydrocarbon, here we will get heavy oil, then we will get kerosene, diesel, petrol, then light hydrocarbon, and here a mixture of gaseous hydrocarbon. So hoping that you would understood the topic very well and will be able to answer if examiner asks this question, how to synthesize petrol in the lab. Thank you.